Hello dear students, welcome to the channel Visual Physics Tutor, the best place to learn the concepts of physics in the most easiest and finest way. So today our topic will be continuous charge distribution. So what do you mean by continuous charge distribution? So assume you have a number of charges closely spaced, then this system of charges closely spaced or closely kept together can be called as a continuous charge distribution. So we can say a system of closely spaced charges is said to form a continuous charge distribution. Now there are three types of charge distribution. So we can call it as linear charge density or line charge density, surface charge density and volume charge density. So now let us deal with the first one, that is line charge density or linear charge density. So we can write here line charge density or linear charge density. So now here we can say that the line charge density is the charge per unit length, and it is denoted by lambda. So line charge density is defined as charge per unit length. So now how do we write it in mathematical form? And line charge density is denoted by lambda. So we can write here lambda is equal to, this is charge per unit length, so it is Q by L, and the SI unit you can see for charge it is coulomb, for length it is meter, so it is meter raised to minus 1. Now the second term that we'll be dealing will be surface charge density. So line charge density, here the charges get distributed along the length of the conductor, and here the for surface charge density we can say that the charges are distributed over a surface area. So we can say that surface charge density can be defined as the charge per unit area. So surface charge density is defined as charge per unit area, and this is represented by sigma. So now how do we mathematically represent it? So we can write here surface charge density, that is sigma is equal to, it is charge per unit area, so it is Q by A. Now its SI unit, you know that for charge it is coulomb, for area it is meter square, so it becomes m raised to minus 2. Now the third will be volume charge density or volume density of charge. This can be defined as the charge per unit volume. So it is defined as charge per unit volume. Now, mathematically, it can be written as rho. Now, volume charge density is denoted by rho. Therefore, rho is equal to, now it is charge per unit volume, so it is Q by V. Now, its SI unit is, for charge it is coulomb, for volume it is meter raised to minus 3. So, it is coulomb meter raised to minus 3. So, apart from this, we will just see now we will write here for linear, for surface and for volume charge distribution. We know that this one is lambda is equal to Q by L. Now for a ring, you can write here lambda is equal to Q by, now what is the circumference of a ring? It can be 2 pi r. So I can write here 2 pi r, that is ring. Now for surface charge density, we had seen that it is sigma is equal to Q by A. So now I can write here sigma is equal to Q by, now we are taking a sphere, suppose. That means for a sphere, the entire surface area will be 4 pi r square. So it will be 4 pi r square. So we can write here sphere. Now for volume charge density, we know that it is rho is equal to Q by V. Now we here again we can consider a sphere, but now we will be taking its volume. So we know that rho is equal to Q by, the volume of a sphere is given by 4 by 3 pi r cube. So 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now again this is for a sphere. So hope you have understood this video, and thanks for watching it.